see what I can do.
Hey, let me ask you something.
Sure, ask away.
It's just, with everything that's happened with you and your family, it's a whole hell of a lot to process. I wanted to make sure you're holding up all right.
Voice of the Minutemen. It's 6 o'clock.
Yeah, I'm all right.
Huh. You're a tougher nut than I thought. Tougher than I was. Took me a long damn time to get a feel for this place. Thank goodness I found Diamond City. It's got its flaws, sure, but it beats the hell out of anywhere else in the Commonwealth. Of course, when I took up there back when, people were just as scared of the Institute as they are now. Maybe more. The massacre of the CPG was still pretty fresh in people's minds at that point. And folks were still losing sleep over the broken mask. Plenty of people assumed I was just a saboteur, moving in to melt down the reactor or poison the drinking water. But at the time, they couldn't exactly turn me away.
Massacre of the CPG? What's that?
The Commonwealth Provisional Government. Years back, a group of settlements tried to get together and form a coalition. Every settlement with even a hint of clout sent representatives to try and hash out an agreement. Only the Institute sent a representative of their own, a synth. The man killed every rep at the talks. The Commonwealth Provisional Government was over before it even got off the ground. I took up in town not long after. I was damn lucky they didn't just tell me to scram right then and there.
Broken mask?
This was long before I'd moved to town, but apparently some gentleman type shows up in Diamond City, heads down to Power Noodles. Guess he didn't like the food because he pulled his pistol and opened fire on the folks enjoying theirs. When security finally put enough holes in him to drop him, they say he was full of servos and sprockets. Just like yours truly. Seems he malfunctioned, went berserk. It was the first time people realized that synths had stopped looking like me and started looking like them. Considering what these folks went through, I felt real lucky they let me in the front gate at all.
Why'd they let you in?
Because I'd rescued the mayor's daughter. Gal of about 15. Pride and joy of the mayor back then. Man by the name of Henry Roberts. The young Miss Roberts decided she'd run off with some caravan hand she'd, known for an evening. Turns out the guy was part of a gang of kidnappers. I didn't even know who I was rescuing. Just stumbled on a crying girl and four toughs. I took her home, and the mayor dubbed me a hero, offered me a place in town. Lots of folks protested, said I was a spy, but he wouldn't have it. Taking up in the city was tricky at first, but I never tried to hide what I was, and people seemed to warm to that.
You took down four guys by yourself?
Well, I didn't have to. Back then, synths were even more of an unknown quantity than they are today. I told them I was rigged to explode and started going, beep, beep, beep. Hardest part of that rescue was keeping from laughing as they climbed over each other to get away.
Was it hard settling in?
Yeah, they sure didn't make it easy. I started off doing the jobs no one else wanted. I got more banged up being Diamond City's handyman than I ever did living out in the ruins. But I guess folks never forgot I rescued the mayor's daughter, so they started coming to me when people went missing. Wife runs off with a new paramour and takes the rent money with her. Talk to the synth. An upset father decides moving him and the kids to Good Neighbor in the dead of night's not the worst damn idea since the bomb. Go get Nick. After a while, the jobs got so backed up, they didn't even ask me to do the handyman stuff anymore. Hell, I was so happy to do it, it was months before I started charging anyone. I never stopped being Nick the Synth, but it was Nick the Detective folks came to see. It was about then that things finally started feeling normal. It took me a long time to realize that home is where you make it. And with some time and effort, this place can be home for you, too. That's a long story, but I hope it helps. Want to get moving?
you'll find what you're looking for. I know.
Try not to sever anything you might miss.
Hey.
I'm all ears. Looking for something? Now, watch this.
You'd better keep your mouth shut about this place.
Seems to be growing well. Carla.
You again. Here to trade?
Did you say something about directions to Diamond City earlier?
Directions. Figures. Just keep going. You'll find the great...
You building a collection or something?
Here for work? We could use some help picking melons if you've got some spare time. I'll give you caps for any you can bring me.
Sure. I got time to help out.
Great. Doesn't have to be now, but whenever you get the time.
That's close enough, stranger. We're a peaceful farm. We don't want any trouble.
It's okay, I'm friendly. Not looking to cause any trouble.
If you say so, but be warned, we're armed here. So don't try anything. Let me tell you, farming ain't easy. Out in the field all day, every day, and every minute of it spent watching your back.
Farming's hard work.
Won't argue with that. Blake Abernathy. Been ages since I've seen one of those vault suits around. You new to these parts?
Yes. And no. It's a long story.
Either way, good to see a new face. How about you? Ever think about working the land?
I'm sure I'll give it a try someday.
Well, good luck to you then. Maybe I'll see you at the Diamond City Market someday and we'll do a swap. Word of advice though, if you do start up a farm, be ready to deal with the raiders. Why do all the hard work when you can just take what you want at gunpoint?
What about the Minutemen? If you join up, we can all help each other against the raiders.
You don't say. I thought the Minutemen were all gone. Last time those raiders hit us, my daughter Mary tried to stand up to them. Now she's buried out back of the house. Only 21 years old, and they shot her down without a thought. So you can understand why I'm glad to hear the Minutemen are back. Although, a bit too late for my Mary.
We're here now. Anything we can do?
I don't have much to offer, but those raiders that killed Mary, they took her locket too. It's been in Connie's family for generations. If you could get it back, it'd mean a lot to us.
Don't worry. I'll get that locket back for you.
Good. Connie feels like it's a part of Mary. I don't think she'll rest easy again as long as it's gone.
There's something you need? Done and done.
No.
for taste. Trouble, I could give
through.
That turns. Who killed the lights? Collecting dust.
Disappearing act, huh?
Show your face. Come on, I dare you.
was the
last time someone came through here. So, this is what 2 centuries without a good dusting looks like.
Any luck finding that locket?
I've got that locket back for you.
You serious? That's great news. Connie's gonna be speechless. Whatever the Minutemen need, you can count on us. We got a decent workshop here, and Connie's sure to go leaner on her prices after what you've done.
What's that?
Thank you.
still a ship lodged in that building.
Scanning. Scanning. Accessing pre-war records. Record found. 108th Infantry Regiment, 2nd Battalion. Ahoy there. 'Tis Providence a member of the Congressional Army is delivered to us in our hour of need.
I was in the Army, but what's the Congressional Army?
Standing orders, sir. Proclamation 3. All members of the U.S. Army are hereby members of the Congressional Army. The captain requests your presence on the bridge. At the double quick, sir.
You're with the Minutemen, right?
The Minutemen are always happy to help. What did you need?
A pack of feral ghouls has holed up nearby, and some of them have started wandering out lately. If more of them start wandering out this way, we may be overrun. We need someone to clear them out.
I'm on it. It's as good as done.
I'll be glad to have them gone.
Thank you.
Got it. Got it. took care of those ghouls that were giving you trouble.
You did? That's great news. Fella, you and the Minutemen have our gratitude and our support.
Attention. Interfering with a law enforcement robot is a felony.
Iron Maiden's out to an early lead, but Piece of Junk's right behind. We got some tough competition out here today. This is one hell of a race. It's another great day out here at the track. You all get your bets in? I sure did.
Hey, did the Minutemen send you? Yes, I'm here to help. What's going on?
There's a group of raiders that won't leave us alone. Stealing our food and supplies, threatening. We know where they're coming from.
Don't worry. I'll take care of those raiders for you.
I hope so. We didn't know what to do.
Brotherhood of Steel, Recon Team 429 Alpha, serial number 3431. It's been 3 hours since I set my distress pulsar. There's been no word from the Paladin or Ferris. Their objective was a satellite array on the coast. They may be out of range. My orders were to hold this position at all costs. The entire site has been overrun. The door won't last much longer. Paladin Brandis, sir. It's been an honor, sir.
This race is really heating up. He's in the camp! Call in the bot! Turn him loose!
Knight Terra Aslan, Brotherhood of Steel, Recon Team 429 Alpha, serial number 3431. It's been 3 hours since I set my distress pulser. There's been no word from the Paladin or Terrans. Their objective was a satellite array on the coast.
Iron Maiden's out to an early lead, but Bishop Jones right behind.
My orders were to hold this position at all costs.
Atomic Dreams is still hanging in there.
The entire site has been overrun. The door won't last much longer.
This is Paladin Brand, sir. Paladin Brand, hell of a race.
It's been an honor, sir.
It's another great day out here at the track.